Hello everyone, this is Varun here. We are coming up with our new plugin which allows you to create business listings just like the Facebook pages with your BuddyPress and the BuddyBoss platform community websites. With this plugin, you can allow your member to add their businesses from the front end, and they can include additional details to the business. I have created a couple of businesses here just for the testing purpose. And with these business pages, you are getting a following option and also a quick call of action button. This can be modified as per your requirement. It is utilizing the group component of the BuddyBoss or the BuddyPress plugin. And we are also integrating a what's new section just like our regular activity feed. So if you all the followers can post something on the activity feed, and admin also can post there, and just like the group component of the BuddyPress, you also have a group owner and moderators on the your business pages, and all the followers what have on the page, they can be upgraded to the moderator role or the admin role by the owner. In that way, you can also assign your page to someone else. Along with that one, we have also included the review functionality, and it doesn't need any third-party integration. It is part of the plugin itself, and anyone of who had followed this page can include their reviews, and these reviews can be disabled from the backend setting. These criteria can also be changed from the admin setting. For the setting point of view, we are offering following options. It comes with their business name, their business description. They can also set their iconic image for their business, and they can also set a cover image for their business. Apart from this one, they can include their basic information like email address, website address, phone number, and address detail. We have also integrated the Google API, so if the API is enabled, yeah, they can get an autocomplete for the address using Google API, and those API will be displayed on the sidebar of the website. Apart from this, they can also include their social link on the website. It is a repeater field, so they can include any number of social media links which are predefined here. And we have also included as a work and education field as a repeater data. So if they are also willing to include some work experience or their educational detail for personal profiles, like sometimes they are an entrepreneur, they want to include couple of their personal details, so they can also include these details. If this doesn't apply to them, they do not have to fill this detail. Just like on the Facebook page, you have these fields. It's your choice, you are willing to use them or not. For a shop owner or a small medium business, they can also have if they have work hours, so they can also include these options like no work hour, always open, permanently closed, or temporarily closed. Even they can also choose what time and from which time they are planning to start and something like this. And suppose that they want to have two different time slots, they can also go ahead and select these time slots, something like this. And these will be displayed on their front end. So by default, I'm going with the always open option. For the shop point of view, we have also added integration for the WooCommerce point of view. So if they want to willing to display certain product category at their profile business pages, they can just have to select a specific tag on the products for the products or the category, and those will be displayed on their shop menu. And these tabs can also be enabled or disabled from the setting. Okay. And we have also given an option to control these tabs if you want to display or they want to hide them. So we have integration for the event calendar plugin, WP job manager, and the WooCommerce. Add action button is close to the Facebook pages, so they can choose what action button they are going to display on this cover section. So by default, they can send them to the send a private message. They can select to send a WhatsApp message. They just have to include their phone number for that one. For the call long, they just have to include the numbers. If they want to include their email ID, they can also include their email ID to get sent as a mail to action. So it's completely their choice. If they want to send them to some third party websites, they can also link that directly there. So based on, there are lots of possible options what can be added there. So they can choose these options and then link to anywhere where they want to display their one websites. And these call action buttons can be modified like this one. So they can choose whatever information they want to display there. Okay. So suppose that if they want to go for the sign up to the third party website, they just have to include the third party website link and then just select for the sign up option. So based on that one, that information will be displayed, and text will be also updated based on which action they have used. Okay. For the sidebar point of view, we are coming up to display this information, who is managing the page or not. So if you want to display it, you can enable it or you can keep that disabled. Okay, and we are also giving, like, suppose that they have created a couple of business pages. This page is not relevant for them for now, so they can also delete it anytime. For all the owners, they can delete it. Moderator will not have the permission to delete them. Okay, for the business point of view, all the business pages will be listed like this one, just like the group layout what we have. They are getting the process where they are displaying the categories to which that particular business belong. And all these businesses are getting a follow option or unfollow option like this one. They can follow it, unfollow it. Based on that one, if someone is following a page and unfollowing a page, it is going to display their activities on the activity section. Okay. Actually, I was created that page. That's why I was not able to unfollow that one. Okay, in the activity section, when someone is creating an activity, it is going to display like this one on the side-wide activity section. So I had posted an update on the page, and that is going to link directly to the page one. Okay, so that is going to link to directly to the business page. Okay, for the setting point of view, in the about section, all the information what I have populated there, that will be displayed like this one. All the social link will be displayed here, and the business hour, whatever business hour we are going to select, that will be displayed in the sidebar. Okay, and as per the plugin setting, going to the backend. These are the coming as a BP business profile, and inside the plugin option, you are getting a general setting first, which allow you to map what will be the page on which we are going to display all the businesses. You have to include your Google Map API key for the autocomplete and the map display for any business. And you can also rename these businesses whatever you want for good for your community. And you can also choose the default cover image or default business avatar for that one. And for the color setting, you can also choose the action button color to match with your color theme. Like we have buttons on the pages, on the sections, on the header section. So you can choose those colors which match with your site color scheme. For the review criteria, you can choose which criteria is good for you. You can remove or add any new criteria easily. And you can also set a member review limit setting, like how many reviews a particular member can post on a particular business. For the member restriction setting, we have a option like by default, how many business a particular person can create. You can put it that limit to one or many, and you can also put a limit based on role. That is going to help you for membership plugins. When you are going to link that with some user role or member type, then it will be much easier for you to put a control based on different roles. Okay, and plugin also support member type. So when we have some member type created on the website, it will also give you option to control them by member type. Okay, for the integration point of view, we have three integrations so far: the event calendar, WP job manager, and the WooCommerce integration. Okay, the plugin is available for the sandbox testing, so you can test it anytime. The link will be posted in the description. For the launching of the plugin, hopefully we will launch this plugin within a week. If you have any feedback or concerns, contact us. Thank you.